नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स, लेट्स टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर. सो फार आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट द फाइव इनेट क्वालिटीज ऑफ life, that is desire to live, desire to know, desire to happiness, desire to power, desire to peace, maya and mahamaya, and talking about shastras and guru tattva, tathya jnana, शाश्वत सत्य, नित्य एंड अनित्य एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द शास्त्रस. सी बेसिकली द वेरी पर्पस फॉर ऋषिस और मुनीस और ब्रह्म ऋषिस to feel that emergence towards introducing natya shastra or shastra basically shastra it is shastra so let's keep it to that level for now. We will take it to natya shastra as this discussion moves on. Was they could understand over a period of time or as the centuries pass by, there will be some kind of changes in the society from the civilization point of view and the society point of view. Of course, one may argue that you are going too philosophical and spiritual towards this understanding of the concept, and it's becoming very complicated for us to understand. The point is, this is where the holistic approach happens, which involves understanding of me and I difference at cross level. Most of the dancers or musicians or individuals start at gross level and then reach to the highest level. The point is, these shastras way back around 10,000 years, as I was speaking about Nasadiya Sukta or the Hiranyagarbha Sukta, which were Shruti based, not Smriti based. These Shrutis came directly from the universe, which unfortunately could not be recorded. And it was more or less talking about human existence and its coexistence at minutest level. The point is, this was more easier for those individuals who were existing during that period of time, because they had that liberty and that environment and that kind of surroundings in and around to evolve themselves. However, they realized it as the civilizations passed away. Civilizations passing away concept also they could foresee. How could they get that is one question one needs to really understand. Forget about their existence as an individual. Irrespective of their existence in the universe, at Anitya level, as I was speaking about Shashvata Satya, there are certain facts and there are certain actions which cannot be really explained. Rather, this has to be understood and felt. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen, this is the practical beauty of Shastras. Before even getting to Natya Shastra, to understand the 36 chapters, one needs to understand where exactly this Shastra started. The question is, what is this me and I concept at a grosser level? When I say grosser level, it's grosser level. And what kind of actions that needs to be taken at subconscious level? Though one needs to understand that goal setting and vision, one of the very major points which one needs to understand is the seers or rishis or Brahma rishis, be it Bharata, Siddhendra Yogi, Ananda Vardhana, Abhinava Gupta, Acharya Charaka, you name it, whomsoever, Bhrigu or anyone, X, Y, Z, did that self-introspection by questioning themselves first, by giving that affirmative statements and having that futuristic goal point. When I say futuristic goal point, futuristic. The futuristic vision is what is needed. Today, unfortunately, the classical dancers or the young dancers or dancing professionals really fail to get to this level. Believe me, I'm not being rude or harsh I have seen dancers dancing. I have understood. The very core part of understanding the holistic nature of the scriptures itself is going wrong, which one needs to understand. The base level of understanding the Natya Shastra itself, we are failing. I am still in the introductory part. Understand this. As I was speaking about desire to live, desire to know, desire to happiness, desire to power, desire to speak, so what you call peace. I have not even touched the Maya and Mahamaya aspect over here. This is the beauty of the Shastras. And they had that agenda. They had that action plan towards what needs to be done. This is one very important point, ladies and gentlemen. And at the same time, the holistic understanding of how far is it good for me and others as well. On a serious note. At the same time, if I really look at the body, so-called, which existed or coexisted, is very simple body, having all the 36 tattvas of Lord Shiva, which Lord Shiva taught. But it has to be in the structured and put that in a schematic way. And again, it's a very complicated concept. Understand this. Unless and until you understand to the core, you will not be able to get to this. And this body is a mere instrument. This is the instrument that helps to generate that positive energy, which gives that innate ability to have that awareness and actions and understand the abilities, your abilities as an individual, what best you can do with the Shastras, how you are doing it, what is the level of understanding that you have, is very important. This is the primary aspect of a teacher or a guru or the scholars to impart this knowledge first, even before getting to the subject of dance or music or yoga or meditation, whatever it is. Specifically for art and culture forms, one needs to really get into this, get to understand this on a serious note. Believe me, this is very important. Now, what kind of knowledge one needs to understand? There are two types of knowledge. One is self-knowledge and other is outer knowledge. The self-knowledge which I am talking about is that comes very much naturally from the understanding point of view. As there is saying, curiosity is the mother of knowledge. One needs to be curious and enthusiastic towards getting this. Guru cannot impart that. Guru or teacher or me, though I am speaking in this video, I can give you the basic level of this knowledge, but if I want to impart that thing, into one's mind. I cannot. I can take a horse to a pond, say that this is the pond and this is the water and this is the way to drink. That's it. It's as simple as that. Now, this self-knowledge and outer knowledge which I am talking about, outer knowledge is something wherein you see with your eyes, you experience that, which was experienced by rishis, munis and brahmarishis, and that's when they could document as smritis. After this is, I'm talking beforehand of 3000 years back. Even before that, let's go 10,000 years back. It was Shruti only. There was no documentary, what you call, evidence for anything. However, one needs to develop that internal natural tendency. Here, to get that, one needs to have the information, proper information. One needs to understand that. This is the beauty of Shastras. And that is one reason why I am emphasizing, first understand Shastras even before getting to Natya Shastra or various other Shastras. Today, Natya Shastra, most of us think that it has happened in 2nd CE or something like that. But we had various versions. The amount of versions that we had were n number, but this thing came into existence as document part, as bits and pieces. There were certain additions, there were certain deletions. In fact, most of us think there are 36 chapters, but there are 40 chapters. There are some of the four chapters that are deleted. Is this hidden knowledge? Gupta Jnana. That is the reason why dancer or yogic practitioner or meditative practitioner or someone who is into fine arts and culture are Sri Vidya Upasakas by default. Irrespective of how they practice, what they practice. And time and again, I am emphasizing, I am telling, I am still in introduction of Natya Shastra's existence and coexistence. Now, there are three aspects. There are certain aspects which one needs to follow. Learning mind, inquiry mind, knowledge acquiring mind. These three were the primary qualities of rishis, munis and brahmarishis. And this does not come overnight. It needs lot of practice, lot of patience, lot of perseverance and lot of penance. Today, most of us, yoga practice as a part of yoga practice or meditative practice or whatever it is, if we are looking at, unfortunately, they are following shortcuts. Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't work that way. It's a very long journey. It requires a lot of practice, patience and penance. And on top of it, it has to come natural. It has to be natural. Absolutely no doubt about it. Now, the self-introspection is very important aspect which one needs to follow. However, the pointers or the key factors from this video is basic understanding of shastras at a minutest level. At a highest level is very important, which one needs to understand. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed, have a blissful life. Shri Guru Pyonna. Have a nice day ahead, and may the Guru's grace be with all of you. Have a nice day ahead, sir.